Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Josh, and this is your stimulus check update for the next stimulus package for Saturday, January 23rd. I hope everyone is off to a good and safe start to their Saturday so far. In this video, I'll be discussing updates in regards to the current relief package and the third stimulus check. I'll also be discussing the $2,000 direct payments, the administration's new plans with the child tax credit, and then I'll be wrapping up this video by answering some of the comments and questions that I received in my previous video. But first, if you wouldn't mind real quickly liking this video, give me a big thumbs up. It really just helps with the YouTube algorithm in terms of pushing this video out to other viewers like you and hopefully helping other people like you as well. Okay, so with some of the more progressive Democrats calling for Joe Biden to go big and the more moderate Democrats seeking bipartisanship, we still have many questions surrounding the next relief package. According to two officials in the White House, the Biden administration is urging Democrats to be patient as they try to reach a bipartisan deal with their Republican counterparts. Over the past few days, Biden has spoken with lawmakers on both sides of the aisle, listening to their concerns about the next relief package, along with proposed changes that they may have. Then, tomorrow, on Sunday, the Biden administration will be meeting with a group of 16 bipartisan senators where they hope to reach some sort of common ground. At the moment, there's almost no question at all that they can pass any bill that Biden proposes in the House. This is because in order for a bill to pass in the House, they just need a simple majority, which the Democrats do have. In the Senate, however, in order to pass a bill the normal way, they would need at least 60 votes, which would not only require every Democrat to approve the bill, but they would also need to have 10 Republicans on board with the plan as well. This way, according to White House officials, is the preferred route for Biden, the bipartisan one. However, even though Biden may prefer the bipartisan route, whether or not he really tries to reach a compromise is yet to be seen. Is the Biden administration and other Democrats willing to significantly reduce the next relief package in order to reach a compromise with the Republicans? Would they say cut the deal from $1.9 trillion down below $1 trillion in order to reach a deal? At the moment, it's really hard saying. With that said, if we received a third round of direct payments either way, would you prefer the next package to be a bigger one, or would you prefer them to still give you a stimulus check, but reduce the overall spending? Let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section below. If the Biden administration and Democrats aren't able to find common ground with Republicans, then more than likely, they'll move forward with a method called budget reconciliation, which will allow them to pass the bill through the Senate with just 50 Democrat votes. Considering they probably don't want to spend several months trying to reach a compromise, it's likely that they would move forward with this approach before the start of March. If they decide to move forward with reconciliation by March or reach a deal by then, worst case scenario, we would be receiving the next round of relief before the beginning of April. Okay, so in other stimulus news, it's now being reported that senior Democrats are drafting a plan that would directly send $3,000 per kid between the ages of 6 and 17 and $3,600 to kids under the age of 6. This would be for the child tax credit plan. So, rather than this being an end of the year tax credit, as it usually is, their idea would be for the IRS to send out monthly payments of either $250 or $300. This would amount to either $3,000 or $3,600, depending on the child's age. This is also something that the Biden administration hopes to make permanent in future years, unlike with stimulus checks, where they're just a one-time thing. Even though the current proposal only has the increase in the child tax credit for 1 year, they hope to force Congress to extend this in future years as well. Of course, there is expected to be a phase-out period for higher income earners, but that amount of income has not yet been determined. According to estimates by the Committee for a Responsible Federal Budget, this could cost taxpayers another $120 billion over the next year alone. Of course, on the flip side of things, even though this would be costly, researchers at Columbia University say it could curb child poverty in the US by more than 50%. Of course, due to the overall price tag, it's expected that Republicans will oppose such a measure, so it's tough saying how they'll move forward with this measure. Either way, if they did move forward with this plan, it would be a great help to families with children, as it would increase their monthly cash flow, and they would not have to wait until they file their tax returns to receive the credit. Even if families owe more in taxes than the value of the credit, for now at least, they would still receive the monthly benefit. So, there are definitely some very interesting developments surrounding the future of the child tax credit, and I'll definitely make sure to keep you updated on that in the future as well. Okay, so at this point in time, I'm going to move right along to answering some of the comments and questions that I received in my previous video. And if you do have any other comments or questions for me, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below. I do try to answer as many of the comments and questions as I possibly can, but for those comments and questions I'm not able to respond to, I do try to pick some of the more popular ones to answer in the next video in video form. Okay, so without further ado, let me go ahead and jump into the first comment of today's video, which is from Renee. Renee says, I am on SSDI and I received my first stimulus by check. I no longer pay taxes. I still haven't received my $600 stimulus. Will I still be getting it? And how long do they have to get it to us? Okay, thank you so much for your question, Renee, and I'm so sorry that you still haven't received your second direct payment of $600. In this case, since you received your first stimulus payment via a check in the mail, I'd expect that you'll receive this one in the same way as well. However, I can't say this for sure, considering I don't have any of your information. What I would recommend for you to do in order to find out for sure is to check the payment portal, which can be found on the IRS website. The payment portal will be your number one resource in finding out exactly when you should expect to receive your payment and through which method. More than likely, as I mentioned, since you received your first direct payment as a check in the mail, this one will come in the same way. If you're like the others I've seen, it was probably sent on January 6th, and even though it hasn't arrived yet, the IRS does mention on their website that it can take up to 3 to 4 weeks for these checks to arrive. Based on that timeline, it could take until February 3rd to receive your payment. If you don't receive your check in the mail by then, I'd recommend to go ahead and claim these $600 as a credit on the tax returns that you file this year. Even though I'm sure you'd much rather receive your money as a check in the mail, rather than going through the hassle of filing a tax return, receiving your money this way is certainly better than never receiving it at all. Okay, moving along to the next question of today's video, which is from Angel. Angel says, did I read an article right regarding the next direct payment, saying you would only get it if you get the vaccination? Okay, thank you so much for your question, and yes, I did talk about that in one of my previous videos. At the moment, there is one lawmaker in Ohio saying that in order for people to receive the third direct payment, they should have to first take the vaccine. However, by all of our lawmakers combined, there are many horrible proposals, and this is just another one. Now, I personally wouldn't blame someone for taking the vaccine or not taking the vaccine. That's their personal decision, but taking the vaccine should determine whether or not you receive the next direct payment, and it won't. The amount of backlash they would receive if they did something like that would be absolutely astounding. So with that said, I wouldn't worry too much because there's almost no chance they would ever go through with that proposal. No chance at all. Okay, moving along to the next question in today's video, which is from Martha. Martha says, are the people who did not qualify for stimulus in the first two rounds going to qualify this time? Okay, thank you so much for your question. And first off, I'm so sorry that you did not qualify for the first two relief payments. For the third round, however, depending on your situation, there's a good chance that you could be eligible. For example, if you're an adult dependent, and that's the reason you missed out on the first two payments, then for the third round, more than likely, you should be eligible to receive one. At the moment, per Joe Biden's plans, dependents over the age of 17 who missed out on the most recent $600 payment would be eligible to receive $2,000 this time around. This would include the most recent $600 one that they missed out on, in addition to the $1,400 one that others will be receiving. However, if you missed it for other reasons, such as your income simply being too high, then more than likely, you wouldn't get this one either. So, for example, if you're making $500,000 per year, which would have made you ineligible to receive a check, then you won't be eligible this time around either. However, on the other hand, if you made $500,000 per year in 2019, but your income dropped to $20,000 in 2020, then you could claim the first two direct payments as a credit on your tax returns, and you would also be eligible to receive the third direct payment as well. All right, so on that note, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video. If you did enjoy the content in this video and you'd like to see more videos like it, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. It is completely free to do so, and it's a great support to me. Also, if you'd like to receive 2 free stocks from Webull, with both of them valued all the way up to $1,600 each, or 1 free stock from Robinhood, just for signing up and linking your bank account, please feel free to claim those free stocks by clicking the link in the description box below. And finally, if you join Rakuten with my referral link in the description box below and spend at least $20, Rakuten will give you $20 cash back. This means that you can buy an item through Rakuten with one of the referral links, such as Macy's or Nike's, for $20, which would be right around $22 after tax, and Rakuten will give you $20 just for making that purchase. This is just an incredible deal that we'd love for everyone to take advantage of. Okay, so until next time, I'll see you guys, and I hope you have a great day today.